I dreaming, or was it you? It was warm, romantic, and we were alone. Let's talk it over. You can call right now. Just you and me. Nobody else.
$4.99 per minute. Must be 18 or older.
For adults only.
I'm not dreaming. This is just a fantasy. Or is it?
Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall here. We've got more great action coming up for you on WCW Worldwide. Before we get back to the mat action, I want to introduce you a man you've seen so many times in action on WCW Worldwide, the pro show, Saturday Night Nitro, Thursday Thunder. He has been everywhere. Dean Malenko, the Iceman, a man who has held that cruiserweight title more than anybody else in the history of the sport. You've been the United States heavyweight champion. I'm wondering, Dean, when does enough become enough? Do you still pursue belts, or do you know that your place really is quite secure in the history of this sport?
Well, Lee, I've been real fortunate in the 2 years that I spent here in WCW to have been 3 times cruiserweight champion and 1 time U.S. champion. And it doesn't stop there, because there's a long list of great competitors here in WCW. And I can sit here and rattle names and names and names. But Dean Malenko is about one thing, and that's about being a wrestler, and about stepping in every single night. No matter what arena I'm in, if it's Nitro, Thunder, a Saturday night taping, whatever it is, that I give 110% of myself. Because I know what you put into this sport, you get out of this sport. And I've been proof of that in the last 2 years. And there's a lot of things I'm still looking forward to accomplish in this great sport, and especially here in WCW. One is, I'd still like a crack at the WCW World Heavyweight Championship. That's one belt that's been eluding me for quite some time. And there's tag teams, there's a lot of things going on here in WCW. And I hope in 98 and the years to come that I'm still a part of it and that I can still carry gold around my waist.
Everybody calls you the Iceman. I think that's because of the expressionless that you don't give your opponent an opportunity to really read your face. I think it kind of psychs them out. Do you do that deliberately?
Lee, it's just something, I've spent 17 long years in this wrestling industry. And when it comes to wrestling, I do my homework. I'm not about facial expressions. To me, it's a sport. It's something that I take a lot of pride in, a lot of dedication, and I'll continue to be the best that I can be as long as I'm involved in this great sport of wrestling.
Boy, I've had a lot of great things to say about this young man over the years. Dean Malenko, come on in. Big Sunday night coming up for you this Sunday, 7 o'clock Eastern time, and available exclusively on pay-per-view, one of WCW's mega events. This one is called Uncensored. You're going to be going Chris Jericho one-on-one for the cruiserweight title. You might give me just a little background of you and Mr. Jericho. I talked to him recently, and he was not complimentary as far as Dean Malenko is concerned.
Gene, Chris Jericho mentioned a word called respect. And respect is something I don't take very lightly. Because to get respect, you got to earn respect. Now, you think of some of the great champions that have held this belt in the past 2 years. Names like Rey Mysterio Jr. And I'll even give credit to Eddie Guerrero. And at one time, I respected Chris Jericho for the athlete that he was. But now we have a new Chris Jericho. A pompous,
arrogant
person that I won't stand for. Because when I think of wrestling, I think of Dean Malenko, someone who takes 100% every time he steps in the ring. And I take a lot of pride in what I do. Chris Jericho, the only thing that me and you have in common, my friend, is we're both 3-time cruiserweight champions. And come uncensored, I'm going to walk out 4 times cruiserweight champion.
If I may interrupt right here, Dean Malenko, I tried to be complimentary to you, a man of known as a man of 1,000 holes, known as the mechanic, and all of a sudden, this young Jericho, being the pompous whatever he is, made light of it all.
I'll tell you can talk all you want. My business is in that square circle, and come uncensored, my friend, step into it, and you're going to be in my office. Talk all you want about 1,000 holes, whatever. I'm a wrestler, and that's what I do best. Jericho, I'm just telling you, show up, bring your belt. One of us is walking out with it, and that's going to be me, my friend.
All right, Mr. Jericho, this Sunday night on pay-per-view at Uncensored, you have a meeting with the chairman of the board. Yes, Dean Malenko, coming up 7 o'clock. Be part of it, Uncensored. Make that call right now.
Guys, thank you very much. I want to take this opportunity now to talk to the Iceman, Dean Malenko. Dean, I think everybody saw recently you were talking to Arn Anderson. Four Horsemen, that was being discussed. My question to you is, in that you've never been a member of the Four Horsemen, why would you care less whether or not the Four Horsemen ever reunite again?
You know, they say friends will do anything for each other, and Chris Benoit is that kind of friend to me. Here's a man that's this close to being a major player in WCW. Now, Chris can make it on his own. We all know that.
But with the knowledge and the wisdom and the experience behind Arn Anderson, who knows how far Chris Benoit, and for that matter, Steve Michael can go. Arn Anderson, I made a plea to you for a friend, and that was it. I was just asking you to look into your heart and to open your eyes a little bit and try to revamp back the Four Horsemen again for my friend, Chris Benoit.
Well, you're a good friend to campaign on behalf of your friend, Chris Benoit. Let's talk a little bit about the Iceman, Dean Malenko. In fact, let's talk about this coming Monday Nitro from San Antonio, Texas, the Alamo Dome, to be precise. It's going to be you and Jericho, one more chance. This is your last chance. Quite honestly, Dean, if you don't defeat Jericho this time, you're never going to get another shot at him again.
You know something, Chris Jericho? This is it. The finish line. No more loopholes. No more conspiracy victim. No more talking about the Malenko family name. Because San Antonio is the last stop for Malenko. The last stop for Chris Jericho. And I don't care if I walk out with the belt. I don't care if I'm cruiserweight champion. I just don't care. Because San Antonio, Texas will be the last place, the only place, these two hands right here will be right around your throat. And once and for all, shut that whining and crying and that nagging, that complaining little mouth of yours. Once and for all, last chance.
Dean, I know that everybody's hoping you put up and everybody's hoping that Jericho will shut up. Fans, we've got a whole lot more action coming up for you as Saturday night continues here on TBS. It's going to be great in San Antonio. Guys, I thank you very much, and I know wrestling fans all over the world are thinking about one thing when it comes to refereeing and how that one revered position requires total impartiality. And as we head into Road Wild, I want to tell everybody that Dean Malenko was assigned to this particular event with Chris Jericho, and I must ask you right out of the gate, Dean, can you be an impartial referee when it comes to the living loophole, the Lionheart, Chris Jericho?
Lee, you've known me for quite some time, haven't you?
Well, indeed I have.
Have you found me to be anything but fair?
Well, no. In fact, I think the whole world saw on Thunder last Wednesday that you made an unpopular but a right-on decision when it came to a match.
I know what it is to be a referee. I've been in this business a long time, and I know what it is to be fair. But I also know that an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, well, let's not go there. Let's look back at the track record here for a second. What Chris Jericho has done to Dean Malenko, found every loophole possible to take away the cruiserweight belt from me. Even got an injunction to have a last match, a last chance, a last opportunity for myself at the belt. But now Chris Jericho finds himself against Juventud Guerrero. And guess who the special referee is? None other than Dean Malenko. And Lee, And to the people out there, I'm going to be fair. I'm going to be as fair and as fair as Chris Jericho thinks I can be.
Well, I don't know if that means you're going to be like Lady Justice with the blindfold weighing the scales of justice, but I think fans are waiting to see what happens. I know Juventud Guerrero is waiting to see what happens. I know Chris Jericho, he's just thinking.
Well, he's going to have to wait to see what happens, and so is Juventud Guerrero. But let's just say this, Chris Jericho, I'm going to be your referee, so don't you ever, ever try to get out of hand at Road Wild.
Fans, Road Wild is coming up just hours tonight. Thanks very much, Dean Malenko. We'll see whether or not those scales of justice are indeed weighed evenly for both participants. More action coming up as Saturday night continues. What a job you've got.